Hello, today on Azure Friday, we've got our good friend Steve Lasker, who is a program manager on the ACR team, and he's going to walk us through some of the great new things that we've been building for container lifecycle management.
Yeah, so thanks, Laura. Thanks for having
me. It's good to see you again.
Yeah.
So talk to me. What's going on with our build lifecycle?
Yeah, so when we think about container lifecycle management, you know, we've been focused on what are customers doing next. Mm-hmm. As customers are moving into production, they're facing a new set of challenges. You know, Docker's great to get things started. We're seeing people go into production, and now we have a new set of asks. And one of the things we've been exploring is, well, what do you do when people stop committing code? Because if you think about it, one of the great things about containers is they contain a portion of the OS, your framework, all your dependencies, so you can build, test, and run them in isolation and know what you have. But it also means that you have those things in your container and you have to think about how are you going to patch them
right.
when you stop committing code.
Right.
So we've been working on some of that space, and that was the basis by which we added the build feature to ACR.
All right. Well, talk to me about what the build feature is.
Yeah, if we look at, so we just kind of have a couple of slides here to walk through some of this. If you look at kind of what I refer to as today's and italics workflow, we have this inner loop experience where people are taking images from a registry building. You know, we've got some really cool features like Draft and Dev Spaces where we're actually working in the cloud. So when we say inner loop, it's really pre-commit. What am I doing with my code before I commit it and other people look at what I'm doing? Mm-hmm. We commit those resources, including our Docker files, and then we have some build system that will build, test, and deploy those. And one of the great things in Azure is the number of services that are taking containers as a unit of deployment. Mm-hmm. Right, we don't think of containers just being Kubernetes or Service Fabric or App Service. Like IoT, if I'm trying to deploy something out to an edge, I don't have IT out there. So it's just a great packaging format. And we think of Azure as one of the better clouds that have containers across more services than anything else, than the others. And of course, you're monitoring this. But as customers start getting on to their next project and they don't make commits to that project that's actually in production, that's the problem that we're trying to figure out. What do you do? Because when you're doing builds, you're pulling the latest of that image and you're getting the latest OS and framework, but what do you do next? Mm-hmm. So those things are running in production and they're great, but as we know, the great thing about containers is they will self-heal, which means you still need management, you still need a registry. And to benefit from the DevOps pipelines that people are setting up, we want to be able to leverage that as part of their lifecycle management. So that's kind of the setup. What we've done in ACR is added this build capability. So in addition to being triggered by Git commits, we can also be triggered by base image updates. So if your image is based on Node or Windows or Linux or Alpine or Java or .NET or whatever it is, whenever those images update, it'll automatically trigger the builds as well. So that's kind of the premise. To jump into some demos, let's take a look at this. Because one of the things that we really love around Docker is its incremental discovery. Mm-hmm. Right? The first thing you do with Docker is Docker run. Mm-hmm. And you don't need to know about a registry. You don't need to know about Docker files. You don't need to know about layered file systems. You say Docker run and it just works. And you're like, success. And then you might learn about a Docker file. Then you might learn about builds. And that's the approach we've taken with ACR build. So we have just a basic Node app here. And I could come over to my terminal here and I can, so let's just clear this out. And I might say Docker build and give it an image, a tag, demo 42-hello-world. And I'll give it some unique ID, and I'll say dot, right? So that's a normal Docker build. I'm going to kill that for a moment just to give an example. And that'll do my build locally, and I'll see the results. What we wanted to do with ACR build was basically duplicate that. ACR build, in fact, let me do it this way, because it's kind of cool to show it turned out. Build that lines up, if I spell it right. Dash T, demo 42, hello world. But instead of coming up with my own unique ID, we actually have a build ID, which you can get directly here. Then you just say dot. and it'll take the local context. So what's really interesting here is what you're seeing is it's not just scheduling a build up in the servers. We're actually using our local directory, kind of pre-commit. So I don't actually have to create a build task. I don't have to do anything, you know, beyond just use the registry I'm already using. And I could already see the results of my builds. Is it going to work?
Right.
And if I'm monitoring the list of it, and if I just see AZ ACR build task list builds, so I'm just watching that here, we can see the status. And in this case, we could see it's running. It's a manual trigger. Mm-hmm. And I can see that kind of running right here. So we stream logs, just like you would expect. It's even in color. So in living color, we have some fun there. And now I could see, you know, how that works. So that's great. Now, the thing that I've done here is because I'm running this on ACR build, by default, we'll push to the registry. And I've set up webhooks in our registry so that now you see it says success. Let's come over here and we'll browse the Kubernetes portal. And we've got a webhook on our registry that will automatically deploy this to our staging environment. So we'll just bump this up a bit. And if we look at deployments, we'll see that hello world. And if we look at the pods, we should see that 13 seconds ago just got recycled.
Right.
And we can see that here. Turns out it didn't actually change anything. So that's kind of the quick iterative experience. And that's kind of what we think of as the entry point. But if you want to take it to the next level and say, all right, I'm actually happy with my build, and my code, and I want to commit it, I want to be able to trigger on git commits. So if we come over here, I just have this snippet of code that we can highlight here. And using the same AZ CLI, we'll just say create a build task. And if we look at the parameters, they'll look very similar to a standard Docker build. The tag, in this case, I can use a dynamic build ID. The name of the build task so that it can be referenced. A git context, build args, so we support standard things. We support secrets as well, secret build args. And of course, a git access token and the registry name. So if I come over here, and we'll just paste that. Well, let's actually paste the thing we want to do. So now I'll create this build task on the registry. So if you're working in Azure with containers, you already have a registry. Mm-hmm. So you don't have any other resources to set up, just add a build task to it. And now that's set up. And now if we come over and we make a change, so Azure Friday is now Azure Lara. We'll just kind of make some changes there. And if we git commit this, hello, Lara. Spelling doesn't count. And we'll push that. Because we've set that up to monitor the git triggers, that easily we'll be able to see as we're monitoring those builds, that was just queued for a build.
It just listened.
It's just monitoring. Yep. It's nothing really too magical. The thing that's there is I didn't need all these other things. It's just part of the registry. Makes it really simple. Now, the thing that I didn't really show too closely there, and let's just take a look at AZR build task logs. What that is going to do is look at the currently executing build or the last build and start immediately streaming that. And as we look through this, what we'll see is not only do we see the output of the Docker build, but we'll also see, I can grab another one actually. There it is, it's almost done. We're going to be able to dynamically parse that Docker file every time it's built and figure out what the dependencies are. So ACR build discovered that this is the image that you built, but it has a runtime dependency. In this case, I've got it as my corporate image in the registry for Node as a base image. If that image ever updates, we will automatically get a build event as well.
Okay.
And you didn't have to do anything special, that's just on by default. And if we come over here, we'll see that that one's done. I think we should come over here and refresh, and we should see a happy Lara. Did that refresh? Pods, 20 seconds, so that should be there. There we go.
There it is.
So That simply, I was able to do a git commit, change, and everything's good. So the next step is, let's show that base image update scenario. So I happen to have the base image here, but of course, this is probably on Docker Hub, or it might be your corporate image. And if I just simply change this, I was going to type Azure, but sometimes it's a little too subtle to see. So we'll just change that. We'll make this the blue version just so it shows up there as well. And as I commit, new version, whatever, as we're watching, our build tasks, we'll first see that that base image itself has got a build task associated with that. So that's going to see, we already see that running, mm-hmm. right? So that's a standard git commit, nothing magical there. But that demo 42 hello world, because it was tracking that, mm-hmm. will automatically trigger as a result of that.
Okay.
Now, there are, like Docker Hub and other places, they sometimes have capabilities where you can specify that. One of the unique features of ACR is we are dynamically parsing that. So instead of somebody keeping it in sync on the server and going to the portal and say, I'm watching node 9, right. and then somebody changes their Docker file to node 10,
right.
and they're still getting updates every right. time node 9 changes, right? It's right. not really too helpful. But what we'll also do is we also track any other build dependencies you have in your Docker file for multi-stage builds.
Okay.
So you can separate those out, whether you want to be triggered by SDKs or just the runtime. So as we see here, the base image is now, it was an image update. So demo 42 is now rebuilding as well. And we'll see that get pushed out here in a moment. And there it goes.
There it is.
So we'll come back over. We should see our pods. That'll refresh here as it does a Helm deploy. Mm-hmm. In fact, if we look, we can actually see here on ACR for demo 42, I've got the webhooks node. And I just click on that, and I can see all of the webhooks that have fired. I could see the payload if I'm trying to troubleshoot mm-hmm. this. And I can also, you know, this is where we do the configuration for our release management. And I can put the scope and so forth. So that should now be a very dark Azure blue, if you will. So that's kind of the base image update stuff. Now, the next thing you kind of might wonder is, like, what about tests? I obviously don't necessarily want to mm-hmm. roll things out. The containers don't replace unit and functional testing.
Right.
They make it easier,
right.
but we still want to do functional testing. And if we look here, I have another sample, this one, and this is a .NET Core app. And here, this one's a little more complicated because .NET is a compiled language. We can build much more efficient mm-hmm. and optimized images. They run much faster, but it takes a little more work, you know, because we have to compile it. I can also run my unit tests as part of that so mm-hmm. that if the unit tests fail, my build fails, and you know, things stop, because mm-hmm. usually we want things to stop there. And we can see that if we look closely, we see, where is that error? So AA2C, I think I just typed it in here before, 2C. And if we look at the logs here, and you know, we even have the highlighted in red,
right.
we can see that it was something expected. And we got amazing, and we were expecting good and great, I think, is what I was expecting
okay.
In our unit tests. And of course, that was something new. So the .NET framework shipped an amazing version. We weren't quite prepared for that. So our test failed. So in this case, it's just our tests. We really want the amazing thing. So what was the other one? I think it was, if that's the error, 2E. So if we look at 2E, we'll see in the logs that it succeeded and the build was successful. And if you also notice, in addition to the runtime dependency that I was mentioning, here's your build time dependency. So we actually are tracking more of those with each one. So that's kind of a big, quick overview of ACR Build. I have one other slide to kind of bring this home of why this is kind of complex and something mm-hmm. that why we're investing time in it. Today, when we think of an individual project that gets built. So I like the Contoso returns app mm-hmm. for Contoso. There's one pull request is one build, is one vulnerability scan, mm-hmm. and I do a test, and I do one deploy.
Right.
So I have this kind of fun with math here. But that's the life of development. That's the way we think about it today. When we start tracking base images and containers become the standard unit of deployment, and we go through mm-hmm. all of the history of Microsoft companies that we've shipped, this was kind of fun to find, and it's all the apps at all those companies. Well, when those are shipping base image updates, we need to be able to schedule and send these notifications across all these apps. And it's not just the life of the development, it's the life of the app.
Right.
So as you're doing unit tests and functional tests, and you're at the end of the project, and you're thinking, nah, I don't need to finish these up because we're almost at the end of the project, it'll be fine, we'll do it manual a couple more times, I won't have to write those tests. This is where you're getting the benefit of those. Because
right.
with ACR Build, we're going to leverage your DevOps pipeline from the time you start until the life of the app, and we'll leverage all that work you've invested up front.
That's fantastic.
So that's the goal. As with anything, when you're running out front on new features mm-hmm. instead of following others, we're going to get it wrong. So we really need your feedback. So please, help us provide feedback. You can contact me. We'll put some links, I guess, below on our user voice and our backlog and
okay.
so forth. And we'd love to hear from you on what works and what doesn't work and what you need from us. And
in the meantime, to go learn more, start trying this out. I see you've got a short URL?
Yeah, we do.
Great.
We've got a little one. We try to keep it memorable. There's ACR Build, and that walks through the OS and framework patching and the inner loop, the mm-hmm. Git commits, and the base image update builds.
That's
and we'll
great.
Have Windows images coming as well as ARM support we have now as well. So you can actually start doing your IoT device builds today.
Oh, that's great.
So that's pretty cool.
That's great. All right. Well, thank you very much for taking the time to come show us all the great things you've been building with ACR and delivering building with Build. So really appreciate
at the Build event.
At the Build
event.
That
was the announcement, so that was kind of fun
build
to talk about.
So thanks again. It was really great to see you again.
Thanks.
So today we've been learning about ACR Build on Azure Friday.